Hi everybody. I want to make this video because I did not see any videos on YouTube on installing front sights on virgin AR-15 barrels. This is a barrel that's never had a front sight installed, and obviously this front sight is not drilled. There's no holes for pins. It's never been on a barrel assembly, and I was looking for pointers on it. Figured I'd do a quick search, you know. And I really didn't find any videos to tell you how to set it up, how to do it, or anything else. So I figured, it didn't take me long to figure out how to do it. And I figured I'd go ahead and show you how to install a front sight, virgin front sight, on a AR-15 barrel assembly that's never been drilled. And you can watch this video and, by looking at the level of difficulty that's involved, determine whether or not you want to buy blank barrel assembly and a bare front sight and install it yourself, or perhaps just buy a barrel assembly that has all that stuff on it. Alright, a few things you're going to need obviously are your front sight, barrel assembly. The front sight needs to match it. The front sights, when you purchase them, are specific to whatever upper you're going to use, so you want to make sure you have one that matches your upper. You're going to need this handguard retainer. Alright. One key thing to remember is that this is going to go on your barrel assembly before you begin installing your front sight, right? You know, once you you need to have something on here when you start drilling this up, or guess what's going to happen? This is this particular piece right here is 25 thousandths of an inch thick, and if your front sight is pushed up against this ledge right, this higher cut portion of the barrel right here, it's going to be off. Your holes are going to be off 25 thousandths, and that's very difficult to fix. It can be fixed, but it's very difficult. Alright, well, to make this a little bit easier for myself, I made one special tool. And this is a spacer washer I made, and it's going to take the place of this. So I can get this out of here and put this in its place, and it'll be just like having it there, and I can drill my holes, I can make alignment marks, I'll be able to see them. Alright, before you get started, what are you going to need? You're going to need, first of all, you're also going to need a pin reamer, a taper reamer. It's a 2/0 taper reamer. Number 30 drill bit, preferably at least 2, and of course your taper pins, and some sort of a block to work these, either a Brownell front sight block or this one. I don't even know what type this is. One of the first things you're going to want to do is align, or get ready to align, your front sight on your barrel assembly by making alignment marks. Alright, I've already made alignment marks on the barrel assembly. I'll show you how I did that. But on the rear, on the front sight, on the rear of it, right where your gas porthole is, I do this part by eye. Now it's probably advisable not to do it the way I'm doing it. You could measure. Let me focus in here so you can see it a little bit better. Alright. Now when you want this lined up, you want a line dead center right on the bottom of this hole right here. So I'm going to make a mark dead center here. All right, it's difficult to do under the camera, but you get the idea. I'm going to scribe a mark dead center of this hole here for a gas tube. All right, and I'm going to just come straight down with it. The reason I don't make a mark up here on the front sight and try to align it with a mark on the front of the barrel is this is a casting and it may not be uniform, and I just choose not to do that. It is a lot easier to see center here. All right, let's say you make a mark, you scribe a line, and it's not where you want it to be. Just fill it in real quick with some a black Sharpie. Let it dry, scribe another mark. It's going to be completely covered up with this handguard retainer, so it doesn't matter if you've got 10 marks right here that you've covered up. but that's what you want to do. Scribe a line right here, find center, and then you're going to center mark your barrel. Alright, the way I center mark these barrels is, of course, you see where the sight's going to sit. Alright, right here's the hole for our gas port. Alright, I put it in the lathe, and it's easier to do on the lathe, because if you try to put a straight edge on this, I mean, we're only human after all. You could be cocked a little bit. It may not be right. I put it on a lathe and I mark it the same way I mark virgin barrel assemblies when I'm installing the components for an AK-47. The virgin barrels, you want everything perfectly aligned, you know, along the AK barrel. You want your front sight, your gas block, everything, your rear sight block. And I do the same thing. I put it in the lathe and I mark center that way. Let's go ahead to the lathe. Let's go ahead and go over there and I'll show you how I mark it on that. It's pretty simple. All right, we've got our barrel assembly in the lathe. I've got a facing tool in here. Anything with a good straight edge on will be fine. Make sure when you have it locked in your chuck that it's parallel. But this is all I do. All right, I run the tool into the barrel at the gas port hole. I find center, and once it's there, I run the tool back and forth on the bed of the lathe, and I scribe a mark. And if it's center, I move it out a little bit. I come back here to the next raised portion of the barrel assembly, run it in, and scratch a mark. And this is what I do on AK-47 barrel assemblies. I can go right down the barrel, and at the front sight, gas block, and the rear portion of the barrel, I can go ahead and mark it all locations, and everything's going to be dead on when I go ahead and install those parts. All right, now that we got it marked, we're going to go ahead and take it back out, go over to the back to the bench, and I'll show you how everything's supposed to line up. All right, once you get your alignment marks made, remember, you don't want to just throw this on here without your a spacer washer or this hand guide retainer in place. But as you can see, you know, just like this, it's easy to see. Well, I hope it's as easy for you to see with the camera and everything as I can, my alignment mark. It's real easy to line up the alignment mark on the front sight to the alignment mark I made on the barrel. With our handguard retainer on, okay, it completely obscures the view of our alignment mark on our barrel assembly. That was no good for me, so I didn't like that. So what I decided to do is I found some metal the exact same thickness as our handguard retainer here, and I made this spacer washer. Alright, it's going to perform the same function. It's going to is providing the space in here that our handguard retainer does. I'm going to go ahead and put it on the barrel assembly. Install our front sight. Now, it's pretty easy for me to look at that, and I'll be able to see exactly how close we are between the alignment mark on our front sight and the alignment mark on the barrel. Alright, it'll let me at least get an unobstructed view of our mark. You can, it covers it up a little bit, but we can still see pretty well. I can see real easy the mark right here on the barrel and the mark right here. I know how far off I am. Alright, now I'm ready to take and secure the front sight to the barrel assembly and get ready to drill it. Alright, now how am I going to secure it on there? Well, it's a real high-tech method I've found. I just use a pair of vice grips, and I've got some thin cardboard doubled over on the jaws, and some masking tape in place. I'm going to go ahead and just clamp it on there. And when I clamp it on this front sight, it's going to squeeze this portion right here, and it's going to snug it up a lot. It will not allow it to rotate on the barrel. And then I'll be ready to put it in the milling machine in my mill vise and get ready to drill it up here. And there's a few tricks there I'll show you involved with that. With regards to making this washer right here, how did I go about making that washer? All right, I've already videoed that. Let's go ahead and cut to that right now, and you can see basically how I made that washer, so you can make a spacer. And you know, it's pretty critical to have it. You got to have some sort of spacer in here before you drill those holes. All right, I'm just going to go over real quick how to make one of these washers. All right, this is going to be the spacer that goes in between this plate and the front sight on our barrel. All right, first of all, you need to know the thickness of this handguard retainer. All right, it's 25 thousandths. Get some metal, it's 25 thousandths. Cut it out, or start with a large sheet. Drill a hole in it. Take one of these step drills that goes up to 3/4 of an inch. Drill your hole in it. Take your snips and go ahead and cut out a roughly symmetrical pattern here. It looks like a little kid cut this out, but that's all right. Now I'm going to chuck it up on a mandrel on the lathe, and we'll grind it, and I'll show you how we make a nice washer out of it. All right, I have an expandable mandrel in our lathe. It's a 3/4 inch mandrel. We've got a 3/4 inch hole in here, snugged it down. I'm going to turn it on, and I'm just going to use this sanding disc. And I'm going to grind on this until we have it small enough for our purposes. I'm going to grind on this until we have it small enough to where we can use it, and it's not going to get in our way when we look at our alignment marks when we put our front sight on the barrel center. All right, it's already shrinking in size. I'll probably take another 1/8 of an inch off the diameter of it, because it doesn't have to be very large in diameter. Just actually, I just barely want it to be maybe 100 thousandths wide. All right, I'm gonna keep grinding on this, and then when I'm finished, I'll show you how it's gonna fit on our barrel assembly. All right, the installation spacer is complete. I polished it up a little bit, but as you can see, it's not very wide. It'll let us get our alignment marks lined up pretty well on our between our barrel and our front sight. Because you want to make sure, you want to be able to make sure that when you're drilling this thing up, that you have everything lined up correctly, right? You don't want it canted off to one side. You want to be able to make sure that you can verify your alignment marks match up. And this washer will do that. It's kind of difficult to do it with this installed. And you definitely don't want to try to drill your front sight assembly up without either one, because this is 25 thousandths. If you drill your front sight without that, now your holes are going to be off 25 thousandths. You're going to need to move them forward to make up the difference for this piece right here. All right, that's how you make that. All right, now I'm ready to set the barrel in the mill vise. One of the things I've got to help me do that is this rectangular block of steel here. It's about 5/8 of an inch high, 1/2 inch wide. It's narrower than a barrel assembly. What I'm going to do is lay that in here in a vise, and what's going to happen is when I put the barrel assembly in the vise, it's going to lay on here. I'll keep it flat on it. I know the vise is true, and what it'll do is keep the barrel perfectly level and true in this plane right here, all right, along the axis, particular plane of the barrel. I have another item I'm going to show you, another trick to keep it true in a rotational axis of it. All right. And this is what I've done to secure the barrel. All right, we've got our sight clamped on. I can see my alignment mark really well. And I'll bring it up towards the camera. All right. I can see that alignment mark, and I'm going to keep it right about here. I'm going to run the barrel, or run the vise jaw up against the barrel, and just barely bump it. All right, it's tight against our block. All right, snug. All right, now that'll keep us parallel, and as far as keeping our hole straight that way. So what do we do about the rotational axis? How do we keep our hole true? All right, on our rear portion of our sight block, there is a hole for a sling swivel. I put a 30 drill bit through there, and that drill bit, I'll run the mill table over, bring this drill bit down till those two are parallel with each other, and then I'll adjust the barrel. I'll rotate it left and right, back and forth, to get it to line up. All right, let's go ahead and bring these two closer together, and then I'll focus in a little bit better, and you can see how I'm doing that. All right, I've put some tape on a shank of our number 30 drill bit. I'm going to drop it into the hole here for our, I guess that's a sling attach point. I'm going to run these two drill bits parallel to each other. I'm going to put the drill bit on the back side of this drill bit here, because I don't have to check. I don't have to put it on its left or right, because I'm keeping that parallel with our rectangular block of steel. All right, I'm just going to look at this side here, make sure our gap is okay, and if it is, we'll get ready to drill that. If not, and it probably will not be, we'll rotate the barrel a little bit to get a uniform gap. That way we have this rotational axis true. All right, I've checked that for being parallel. It is. I will run my drill chuck up, take our drill bit out of there, get it out of the way. And we'll get ready to drill our hole. As soon as you start to drill your first hole, one of the things you're going to want to do is double check your alignment marks. You want to make sure that it's still aligned. All right, another thing I'm going to do, now I've got it just about where I think it, I'm going to plunge the hole, is I'm going to take a straight edge, put it on the back side of the barrel, and I'm going to look at it and check and see where it is in position in relationship to our drill bit. That'll give me an idea of where our drill bit is. You know, make sure that I'm actually going through barrel material when I run it down. All right, at this point, I'm going to do something different than what I'm going to tell you to do. My drill bit is new. It is sharp. What I'm going to do is real carefully go down. I'm just going to go down to the tip of the drill bit, starts to touch our sight block, and I'm going to check it for wobble, and if it's not wobbling, I'm going to slowly cut a few thousandths of an inch until the hole starts. All right, you could also use a center drill. Center drill would be even a better idea. You can start your hole with your center drill, and then when you come back with your drill bit, you don't have to worry about the tip of the bit wobbling on you and giving you a crooked hole. So this is one of those cases where don't do as I do, do as I say, all right? All right, I've got a little bit of cutting fluid on there. Slowly running the drill bit down. sight lock. The drill bit hasn't moved. It's not locking. All right. Cut into the surface. Now I'm going to stop and I'm going to double check and make sure that our sight alignment marks are still aligned. All right, everything's still perfect. See, that's the reason for this spacer washer I made, is I can double check. It's real easy to double check the alignment throughout this drilling process. And I go really slow. If you go too fast, you have to worry about the front sight being pushed around the axis of the barrel. That's why this clamp is on here. It helps keep it from moving. Use a sharp drill bit and go slow. All right, let's go ahead and put some cutting fluid on that. Put a little more cutting fluid in there. We've got our first hole drilled. So what I'm going to do now is move the mill table down just far enough so that I can drop this 30 drill bit in. Alright, the shank goes in, nice snug fit. That's going to help me whenever I move this vice grip over. I'm going to move it to the back side. Right here, that way I can keep pressure on that. All right, now that I've moved my vice grips, I'm going to double check our alignment mark, make sure it hasn't moved. Just a little more cutting fluid, now we're ready. Again, I'm going to do the same thing I did before. I'm going to watch the tip of the drill bit, make sure it doesn't lock. Again, if you use a center drill, you don't have any chance of that to begin with. As I start to drill, I'm going to watch my alignment marks. Nothing should move because I've got the vice grips in place and the drill bit shank in the hole we just drilled. So that should prevent anything from moving. Okay. Finished drilling at this point. Go ahead and take this out of the vise, take it over the workbench where we can take a look at what we've done.